Hey YouTube, how is it going? How you guys doing? I hope you guys are doing fantastic. If this is your first time checking out Two Little Vines channel, what is up? I'm Amy. If you're returning, welcome back, guys. So hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Show me some love if you're new. If you are returning, welcome. Bless you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting me always. So I am going to do like a love relationship, twin flame relationship, however it's connecting with you. Whoever you're connecting with, this is going to be a message for you. I'm going to use my Romance Dorian Virtue deck to get you guys a message today. So with that, let's get started. All right. So Spirit and Angels, what is going on with the collective twin flames, collective males, relationships? What is going on? What is the message that needs to be heard? What is the message that needs to be heard? What is going on with the current connections? Whoa. Okay. Hello. Hello. I got some cards coming up. All right, so for those that are in a current relationship, for those that are, you know, connecting with someone, whether it's your twin flame, whether it's your soulmate, Spirit is saying today, this week, whenever it resonates with you, that your love life, your love connections right now, children could be a major impact on that, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. It could just be that there's indifferences, there could be some blockages, there could be things that need to be overcome. Maybe this person doesn't want to step on boundaries. Maybe this person doesn't want to step in and take over. I feel a sense of if you're in a relationship with someone, this person's having a hard time trying to maybe they don't like the way that your kids are treating you. Maybe they maybe they're afraid to step in and say something. Like, it could be anything. There's another scenario that just popped through where, your romantic partner or the person you're connecting with, maybe they want children and you can't have children, or maybe you want children, but they don't want children. There's just this disconnection around children. There's either a disconnection or a misunderstanding. If it comes to your twin flame, I feel like he could be dealing through like a divorce or something, and that's what the blockage is. He could be dealing with some major impacts when it comes to his children. But just know that whatever is happening, your love life is being affected because it centers around something to do with children. Okay. But like I said, I don't necessarily feel like it's an overall bad thing. I just feel like it's kind of one of those messages that need to be heard. All right. At this time, I feel like whoever you're connecting with, either in your relationships, in your connection fields, at this time, it's about getting to know each other. About, you know, sometimes we want things to rush, or things to happen, or commitments to come along. And Spirit is saying, you're in a phase of just being able to enjoy the moment. You're being in a phase of just being able to sit back and get to know this person for who this person is, because you don't want to just jump into a commitment of marriage or, you know, engagement and not really know who you're about to walk down the aisle with, right? Because somebody can be someone, and then when you marry them, they can be a completely different person, if that makes sense. Because that's what I'm feeling. I'm feeling like whatever the slow progress is right now, whatever feels like it's not happening for you, it's not that it's not happening for you. It's happening to you, but in a good way of like Spirit is like slowing things down so that you can kind of just get to know someone. If this is your twin, your message is that Spirit, when your twin does come back towards you and comes into union with you, Spirit wants you to get to know him or her, however you see the twin. I always do him and her. That's just easier for me to reference, but however you reference it, go ahead. And I feel like what Spirit is saying is that at this period of time, whether you're in a twin or soulmate relationship or connection, whatever connection you're in, it's just about getting to know each other. It's about, you know, having faith and having trust that you two are exactly where you're supposed to be. And if you're not in connection with your twin right now, it's like getting to know each other, but getting to know yourself. I feel like I've been saying this for a while now about how, you know, in relationships and connections, the main thing is that you need to be loving yourself. Because if you can't love yourself and if you can't get that time and attention to yourself, how do you expect to love other people? Okay. So getting to know each other is definitely coming up strong. True love. This is the romance of a lifetime. Okay. So this connection you're in, this romance you're in, Spirit is saying, this is a true love connection. This connection is divine. It was sent to you. It was brought to you. Whether it's your twin, whether it's your soulmate, whether it's just a love connection. This person is in your life for a reason. They're here for a reason. This could be the one. You've already met the romantic partner you seek, okay? So this tells me that you are in a connection with someone. You're in a relationship with someone. It could just be slow going. You could feel like, well, I've been with this person for so long and they're still not committing to me on a level of engagement when I know that I'm worth it. Okay, well, you know that you're worth it. So you know your worth and you know your value. If you're expressing that, then that's all you can do, unless you decide that this relationship or this connection is not one you want to stay in. Spirit is saying, like, you're in a place where some of you need to slow down a bit. Some of you need to just be like, you know what? I'm gonna let everything unfold. If it unfolds where we get married, perfect. If it doesn't, then I know it's not meant to be. But some of you are in a relationship right now where Spirit is saying, this person could be the one, but don't push it, Don't try to rush things, allow things to unfold naturally. Some of you are calling in your soulmate. You're doing affirmations, you're doing prayers, you're visualizing this marriage, you're visualizing things, and that's good in a way. Like, it's good that you're visualizing that because you're calling on what you want, and we always want that. We always want to call. But what will come to you will be for you. And that's what I always say to my clients, and I always say to my people, what is for you will be for you. Okay? Some of you have religious factors right now. There's religious differences that are going on that are influencing your love. And we have to see that sometimes that is a blockage. But whoever you're connecting with, whoever you're in love with, whoever you want to be with, it could just be that you guys need to have that deep conversation. You need to have better communication skills. Any more messages for the collective? Any more messages for the collective spirit? Okay. Look at this. Trust. Okay? The situation is calling you to have faith. Worth waiting for. Divine timing is at play. So it may feel like, Amy, like nothing is happening, or I feel like nothing is coming together, and I feel like I'm not being heard, or I feel like I know I deserve more, but it's not coming through. And Spirit is saying, like, I feel a lot of us live in ego. I feel a lot of us live in fear. I feel a lot of us as divine feminines, we haven't let go of, what has hurt us in the past, which it makes us feel like nothing ahead of us is going to be worthy. And I feel like as a divine feminine myself, who does that, who's taken on my previous relationships and hurt and pain, have brought it into my new ones, it's this point of feeling like I'm always living on edge, if that makes sense. And I feel like for you guys, it's just about knowing that everything is a divine plan, everything is going to work out. You need to have trust and you need to have faith. This is a true love. This is something that is supposed to last. It's just about getting to know one another. It's about knowing that there's going to be blockages. There's going to be, things that are going to be in the way of your twin flame connection or your romantic relationship connection. But it's all about how you're looking at it right now, So I'm going to do you guys a quick Oracle love message and then I will get off. Let me know too, guys, if down in the comments for those who watch me on a regular basis and support me, if you guys would like me to go live more often, because I feel like I'm not sure if my, subscribers would like that. I've been going live more on Facebook and for my page and my twin flame group, but for YouTube, I haven't really gone. I've gone live a couple times, like over a year ago, but not recently. Spinning Angels, what is the love message for the collective? What is the love message for the collective? What is the love message for the collective? I just got this one too, relationship for I think it was my twin flame group today, where pretty much it talks about how we need to love ourselves more, and that's what I said, but I'll read it for you guys. So if you're struggling to find loving and meaningful relationships, it may be worth checking on the relationship you have with yourself. Our relationships with others mirror the connection we have with ourselves. If you feel you are not enough, you might give too much too early and be taken advantage of. If you feel you cannot be loved for who you are, your relationship might be shallow. If something is lacking in your relationship, look to what is lacking within you. It is not your sole responsibility to make a relationship work, but when you come to the world feeling undeserving of love, you are more likely to accept something less, thinking something is better than nothing. But wait, for love will come. Search for love and meaning and connect with those who can help you find it. All transforms when me transforms, okay? So, like I said, I know it gets hard, especially with a twin flame journey, because a twin flame journey is so hard, right? We don't necessarily always understand why our twin doesn't want to come forward, why our twin doesn't want to talk to us, you know, why it's taking so many years to come into union. And I feel like a lot of divine feminines forget that, you know, not only is there lessons and obstacles and challenges, but it's you gotta have that relationship with yourself. You have to have that, you know, if you're not healed and you're not, and your divine masculine's not healed, there's no way you guys can come together, because it's going to be this one big firework, you know? And I feel like that's the message for you guys, is that if you're not with your divine masculine right now, it's because there's obstacles. There's still something that needs to work out. There's like kinks, right? If you're in a current relationship right now, it's knowing that this is, you know, a trusting, loving relationship, knowing that you two are meant to be together, knowing that it's going to rise up and go to higher commitment. But right now it's about having faith and trust and what you guys are developing now, and just, you know, enjoying each other and getting to know each other and just moving from there. All right. But don't forget to have that relationship with yourself, and don't forget to love yourself, because I feel like that's two strong points from this reading. But I love you guys. I'm sending you all love and light. Please hit the like button. Please subscribe if you haven't. And I'll talk to you guys soon.